Good morning, everyone. The today's class of non-destructive evolution, we would like to discuss regarding the liquid penetrant testing methodology that is widely used in the olden days in non-destructive testing of the materials. Coming to the syllabus point of view, this is the second unit. This will be displaying your syllabus which is in unit number 3. It is a liquid penetrant test and eddy current testing process. Particularly in the unit number 2, we'll be having the ultrasonic testing process that we'll be seeing in the next class. Coming to the point of this liquid penetrant testing process, as far as your syllabus has been considered, what is the main principle of this liquid penetrant test? What are the basic concepts behind this for using this liquid penetrant test? And what are the equipment that is considering in the system? What are the sequence of steps that need to be followed for examining the different kinds of defects that are existing on the specimen in the experimentational process? How far this process can be examined, its highlights, nothing but the advantages where it is mentioned as effectiveness, and what are the drawbacks or limitations are existing behind this liquid penetrant test, and different forms of applications will be coming across in our lecture videos. Next, to the eddy current testing process. So we are having the electrical concepts based on these Faraday's laws and Lenz law concepts. These two plays a major role. We need to study this eddy current testing process, which we will be seeing in our nearest class. What is the basic principle of this eddy current? What are the laws that are existing behind this to operate this testing methodology? In what type of systemic zones we will be exercising this eddy current test? What are the applications that are existing behind this? Operating parameters, advantages, limitations, and applications will be seen in our classes. In the today's class of lecture, we'll be moving on the basic introduction related to the liquid penetrant test, how it is examined, and for what purpose it will be utilizing, and the ancient history related to this liquid penetrant test, particularly to concise or to the surface levels of the inspection methodology, this test plays a major important role. The history behind the testing process, etc., will be looking furtherly. Coming to the basic principle of this liquid penetrant testing process, this is the inspection that has been carried in the olden days, and even in some of the cases, as we have discussed now, that is to inspect the surface finishing of the objects, this test plays a major role, but it is limits to particular extents. Nothing but the porous kind of surface finishings cannot be examined by this testing process. The finishing should be very much clean, and non-linearity should not be existent. Almost all the materials can be utilized. The basic phenomena of this liquid penetrant test is nothing but existing in two kinds. It is operating with respect to the chemicals used as in liquids, whether it may be applying directly on the specimen or indirectly on the specimen, as will be utilized in the spraying concept. The acidic solutions, in that operating solutions, the acidic solutions will be existing and basic solutions are also will be existing. When physical lead has been applied in some of the materials, which can be operated in the normal atmospheric range of temperature and open conditions, normal atmospheric range of temperature and even in the open conditions. At that particular time, due to the oxidation process available in the environment, the materials will get reacted and the color orientations will be changing where the defects are being identified. Only at the way defects are being identified. Here in the diagram, it is clearly negotiating that there's a small crack. This is a pictorial representation taken by the microscope, which cannot be visualized with respect to our naked eye. But after getting reacted with respect to the solution, the color will be getting highlighted due to the color impregnation at that cracked area like this. This color may be of the red color or else the yellow color or orange color. Normally we use it to examine in our domestical way of purpose also. The normal acid for cleaning purpose it will be utilizing where the algae is very much highly existing in our washable areas. Algae, that is an algae. So at that particular time, this acid will be sprayed over there. Upon reacting, the acid will be in gold color and the algae will be in green color. Upon reaction with respect to the oxidation, conveyed, it is happening in the environmental criteria, normal atmospheric range of temperature, and in open conditions, it's clearly specifying these operating points. So upon reacting, the color will be existing with respect to yellowish in nature. And upstream foam will be of some light whitish green in nature. So that is the acidic solutions. And due to the basic solutions or the basic laponants utilizing in this liquid penetrant testing process, internally it will be applied on the colored objects, the whitishness and highest foam will be getting generated in the case of this basic solutions upon reacting with respect to the specimen cracks. So what we need to observe in this is the cracks at the surface levels, which cannot be visible to the normal visual inspection. The penetrants in the form of the solutions will be lapped on the material. On the reaction basis, the color orientation only at the cracks will be getting highlighted by its impregnation towards changing in its color after getting reacted with respect to the internal material of the specimen. And the cracks will be identified very much clearly. That is the principle of this liquid penetrant testing process. Anciently, this is the process very much widely utilized. And in the present days, it is concised to only some of the particles, some of the objects within the industry to be examined. Moving on to the penetrant process for testing. This can be applied in most of the materials, that is in both the metallic kind of materials and non-metallic kind of materials. In the non-metallic and even in the case of this metallic, ferrous and non-ferrous kind of metals. Most probably this blazon quick results in the case of non-ferrous kind of materials. Those are aluminium, magnesium, titanium, which plays an primitive most points or primitive most nature presently utilized in NEM by the number of automobile industries. And not only in the automobile industries, in our domestic purposes of manufacturing different kinds of goods, in the furniture range, and aluminium and magnesium and even the titanium are the primitive most materials which is playing a role in the manufacturing of aviation technology. And even in the cast of the materials that are related to the stainless steels. Stainless steels. Iron powder, metals produced as the copper, brass, bronze, etc. And even in the ferrous kind of materials also, cast iron, mild steel, etc. These non-metallic materials includes the ceramics, polymers, and some of the composites, and the resistible grade of materials such as glass, which is having high ductility capability, rubber, fiber materials, asbestos fiber materials, which will be utilized for leakage proofs in the industrial sector. And we have a major limit, as we have been discussing just now, that penetrant testing cannot be applied on the porous surface, where the tiny holes in the surface finishing is being existing, the porous surface, jellied around it, aspects at that particular place cannot be utilized because the laminate will not be settled on the surface and almost all the pores will be highlighted as an defects and hence cannot be examined properly and hence it is not suitable in the case of this porous like kind of structures as an surface finish and even at the edges of the specimens also. Coming to the testing history, in the olden days of 1900s, it is used to detect the locomotive parts. And the nomenclature of this penetrating testing process in the olden days technology is oil and whiting. Oil and whiting. So applying of the lubricants, there is an acidic lubricants or chemicals, chemical lubricants. And when it has been reacted with respect to the carbon containing of materials with highest percentage, that is the materials which are being entering into the hypoeutectic region and even hyperketectic region simultaneously, even the carbon is being increasing eutectoid region, and again it has been subclassified into two ranges, that is hypoeutectoid and hyper-eutectoid region. We all know that from iron-iron carbide diagram in from the MMS subject in the second year, you are having this iron-iron carbide diagram and the corresponding cooling curves related to the different kinds of alloys of the materials based upon its composition. So these percentages for each and every kind of the materials that are available in the universe will be having a minimum carbon percentage of 0.08%. And later on, the materials which are being increasing in its percentage will be entering into the hypoeutectoid region and eutectic region and hyper-eutectic region based upon its carbon percentages. And ranges of the temperature will vary its state of offense, whether it may be of in liquid, semi-solid, semi-liquid and solid, completely gaseous, etc. That will be ranging with respect to temperature as we have already dealt with it. Hence, the highest ferrous content of materials, the point here it is, the highest range of ferrous content of materials will be increasing in its strength due to the capability or percentage in its composition with respect to the carbon. As we have discussed the point, carbon, where it has been reacted with respect to the carbon, the white situations will be getting taken. That is nothing but foam will be generating in the form of white color. That's what the clear point here will be discussing. Next, the method used, dirty lubricating oil that was stained with respect to kerosene, followed in the application of chalk coating and corresponding oil that will be highlighted from the cracks. So chalk coating. Chalk coating is a whitishness in nature coating. So it will be taken in the emulsified format. There is powder in state, amorphous state, and that will be applied over it. And this dirty lubricant will be lapping on the specimen or locomotive indeed to find is there any cracks that are being existing or not. If at all this has the hardness has been not tested with respect to the perfect casting analysis, hence the power transmission between one wheel to another wheel will be getting destructed and maybe leads to the damage. So that's the basic phenomena of verifying or testing by this penetrant process. Even in the fitting range also, this process can be utilized. When you have been observed, the less power transmission is being taken place, we can utilize this technology by spraying this chemical fixation of lubricants on the materials which are being existing at the susceptible area, only at the susceptible area. And even if you have been given this to a limited range, those lubricants itself access and self accessing without getting corrosion, nothing but a resistance free will be increasing with because of the materials are prepared, locomotive materials are prepared with respect to the highest ferrous content of materials. And in 1940s, fluorescent or visible dye was added to the oil in the case of spraying of these lubricants. This is a basic historical review related to the penetrant testing, how in the olden days will be utilizing this liquid penetrant test for identifying whether the materials which has been prepared in the process of casting achieved the correct mechanical properties or not, such as strength, stiffness, geometrical specifications, by following the allowable limitations or shrinkage allowances, etc. Almost all the allowances, whether they has been obtained the perfect mechanical properties or not, to the material can be identified very much clearly. Coming to the basic introductory part related to our testing review. This module is intended to provide the introduction to the entity of penetrant testing, applying of this penetrant. We can come to visualize where the crack is without utilizing any of the external equipment, indeed to verify the cracks or identify the defects that are being existing on the surface of the objects or specimens. This penetrant test increases the seeability of small discontinuities. Initially, before applying the penetrant, liquid penetrant on the surface finishing, which we cannot visualize them by our naked eye, only with respect to the microscopic technology we use to verify those cracks. But after applying this lubricant, as we have been discussed in the theoretical class, that upon the oxidation process will be changing its color pigments, and that pigments will highlight the cracks on the materials upon reacting with respect to the specimen. And hence those color pigments highlights to the normal human eyesight to detect alone without utilizing the external devices such as microscopes or utilizing the technology of microscopes. Coming to the outline of this liquid penetrant test process, we'll be discussing the general introduction point. What are the different kinds of materials utilized as penetrants, and on what conditions different types of materials has to be utilized, because we are having different kinds of materials to be inspected in the industrial sector. Considering an example, manufacturing of an automobile, we'll be taking an example of our bike, engine parts, and entire the casing parts will be getting assembled, or those parts will be getting manufactured with respect to the composition of iron. And rest of the parts such as handles, forks, and fitting of the external tops, etc. will be utilized. Those parts will be getting manufactured with respect to non-ferrous content of materials such as aluminium, magnesium, titanium, palladium, etc. By considering that, with respect to the different kinds of materials which need to be inspected in the case of specimens, the considerations need to be followed, and the types of penetrants should be utilized based upon the type of materials. That's what the point here it is. Next thing, what are the basic steps need to be followed in the case of this penetrant testing? What are the common equipment that is being existing to identify the defects on the specimens? What are the advantages, limitations, and applications related to this? And here the summary relates to some of the highlight points in the experimentation process. What are the different conditions need to be followed, and what are the necessary precautionary steps need to be taken in the examining process, and the glossary of the terms, glossary in the sense a sequence of steps to be reviewed for commencing of the experiment. Coming to the outline of this process, how does this penetrating test works? We'll be having this penetrant test with respect to a liquid with high surface wetting characteristics supplied to the surface of a component which is to be examined, and these penetrants into that particular surface will be getting broken only at the discontinuities, and even the material which we are being utilizing as a specimen should be very much confined with respect to the environmental conditions. Next thing, the penetrant liquid which is being applied on the material also should be highly reactive with respect to the atmospheric conditions. These two points need to be highlighted. And third one, it is the excess penetrant. If the penetrant which we have been applied on the surface finishing of a specimen doesn't evaporates, so evaporates in the sense, this is a small example we'll be taking. Presently we are utilizing the sanitizers. So when you have been taken into our hand and wiping it out, it will be exposed to the atmosphere. And initially, when it has been applied, it will be having a wetty nature, and after it is getting to the environmental conditions, exposed to environmental conditions, it is getting evaporated. And it is reacting with respect to the germs that we are having in our hands also. And the germs are being killed by that sanitizer, which cannot be visualized to our naked eye. Second thing, simultaneously, there's liquid, some of the liquids which are having explosive nature to the environmental conditions will be applied on the surface of the specimens. And where the cracks are being identified, only at that particular range of cracks existing will be getting reacted to the material due to the environmental oxidation process will be taking place due to the environmental conditions. And only at the porous natures or cracks existing portion will be getting its changing in its color because of oxidation process due to the penetrant as a liquid will have been applied. And rest of the area also will be applying the similar material, but it is exposed to the air and will not be having the wet conditions. Only at the crack points will be having the wet conditions, that too with respect to the changing in its color. That is the basic principle of phenomena related to the liquid penetrant testing process, just we have seen the basic definition of it. The principle of operation towards it. And with good inspection technique, visual indications of any discontinuous present will become the apparent. Here clearly specified that apparent. It's nothing but a clear-cut visual nature, visualizing nature. And this is what type of exposing kind of penetrants utilizing. And what makes it the penetrant test work? So in almost all the conditions, this penetrant will not be having its changes with respect to the environmental criteria. So hence, what is the basic factor that is existing behind this to work? So every step of penetrant process is done to promote its capillary action. So here, the capillary action in the sense, raising of its capacity or lowering of its capacity in the form of its level and in the form of its level. That will be changing according to the criteria. Let me see, let me give you a glance regarding this, how the liquid will be getting raised itself. Some of the persons may be having it. They're having the thermometer, that is having enclosed in the mercury is having very much in minute quantity, which is arrested or which is enclosed in a bulb. Based on the external temperature increment, it is indicating by raising in the scale notations. Simultaneously, in our observation also, the capillary actions will be getting raised. That is the best example nominally we used to find in our manual process. And this is the phenomena of liquid raising, same as we will be referring in the thermometer, liquid rising or climbing and confined to small openings due to the surface wetting properties of the liquid. When we have been applied the liquid simultaneously on the specimen, where the capillary actions are being considered, nothing but cracks are being identified, capillary actions will be taking place. And how it will be exercising, sir? So we are having another one more examples, some more examples here. Plants and trees draw the water up from the ground to their branches and use to supply their nourishment. In the plants, regularly we used to observe that the mineral sources with respect to the water content, from the root state onwards, it will be supplying from stem to stem to the different kind of branches, branches to the leaves, the leaves to the flowers and the fruits, if at all any kinds of trees are existing. The human body has miles of the capillaries that carry life-sustaining blood to our entire body parts. And here we are having one more device, that a heart that used to pump the material for blood to different parts of our body. If you have been raised your hand to upward direction, simultaneously a backflow of blood will be creating, and you'll be observing for after a particular time of 2 minutes or 3 minutes, you'll feel that you're losing your sensuousness in your fingers upon continuous raising of your hands towards the upward direction. And normally when you have surrounded to normal zone and downward direction, the blood will be again flown towards it, and you'll be sensing the action again, or else action will not be considered. So that is also one of the best examples towards this capillary raise. We need to identify the cracks. What are the basic process are being existing in the case of this penetrant testing? First one, cleaning and drying the component which we need to inspect. So nothing but from the unconditional basis to the material is being entering into the input testing process. Second thing, it is applying the penetrant, whether it may be of the acidic solution or else the basic solution, will be applying on it for inspecting the cracks only on the surfaces of the materials, and only the surfacing of the materials. Second thing, the removing the excess material. So after the insertion of the material towards the cracks, if there is any cracks identifying by the liquid, it will be submerging or involving, adhering to the internal structures of the small cracks. And the upper layer of this liquid penetrant or the penetrant which we have been applied has to be removed by applying a high stream of water, or else by, if at all it is non-reactant, can be removed with respect to the small cloth also. And next thing it is applying the developer. So here developer plays a major role indeed to highlight the cracks which are being identified by the penetrant. So the third material is different and developer is somewhat different, right? So this developer will give a clarity of visualance that where the cracks are being identified, and rest of the part also will be very much clear that there is no any identification of cracks. And here the pictorial representation clearly negotiating to us. And finally, we'll be having the high intensity upon this developer identification. So it will indicate with respect to the glands. Right? These are the basic steps that we use to apply indeed to verify the cracks only at the surface finishing, which cannot be visible to our naked eye. Right? That is the basic principle of this liquid penetrant testing process. And these are the steps that need to be followed to conduct the experiment for verifying the penetrant testing process. And finally, the post-clean component. After the identification, the concerned remedy actions will be taking place for fulfilling these cracks in order to increase the strength for the materials and its surface also, if at all. And we are having some of the treatment processes also, which we have been discussed in MMS subject also. That is normalizing process, nitrating process, increasing of the strength to the materials, and even that can be resisted to the applied external loads to a maximum level. Nothing but increasing of its resistance capability due to the externally applied loads. And almost all the mechanical properties such as strength, stiffness, malleability can be increased. So these are the basic steps. And what are the objects can be inspected? Almost all the objects can be inspected. There is ferrous metals, non-ferrous metals, polymers, and even in the amorphous state of materials towards the casting process, confiding materials, almost all the materials can be inspected by utilizing this liquid penetrant test. But only the one limiting point is nothing but for non-porous kind of surfaces, it cannot be identified. So non-porous in the sense, this is a best example of it. But uncountable range of pores will be existing in the surface level. What will be calling in, that is general. That cannot be identified. And what cannot be inspected via this penetrant testing process? So rough surfaces with high rough finishing cannot be identified because high peaks and thrust will be existing. Sand castings, because that will not be having a definite structure towards it. And porous ceramics, actually porous only ceramics or else non-ceramics also cannot be utilized for examining in the case of this penetration testing methodology. Wood and other fibrous materials, because it will not be reacted with respect to the environmental conditions. Only it will be directly transforming its stage from one form to another form. Nothing but if you have been applied the solutions such as kerosene or petrol towards the wood material, and if any of the electron-oriented situation has been commenced over that, it will be lighting a fire and transforming it continuously to the outer format, amorphous state. And hence, those kinds of materials cannot be utilized towards it. Components with coating and prevent penetrant from entering the defects. Those also cannot be inspected because it will not be getting reacted due to the labeling conditions. The penetrant will not be getting reacted on the targeted internal kind of materials. So these are the materials can be tested and cannot be tested. And rest of the part we'll be discussing in the next class. Almost the time has been concluded. We'll be meeting in the next class.